Steve Stout basically brought us the whole idea of doing the McDonald's jingle. When he brought it to us, he gave us the "I'm loving it," tagline.
Yeah,
and we basically just wrote to that.
So you just wrote da-da-da-da-da?
No. But, within that, they just took pieces out, whatever the case may be.
I feel like McDonald's shouldn't have wanted to work with this guy.
But no.
Victor again.
And they got over. Pay a one-time payout.
Oof.
One-time payout.
Wow.
I said that.
The union.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Wasn't hip. What was it? Like a half. Me and my brother gave me and my brother a half. Oof. Half a million.
Oh, that's a pretty good payout, though.
No. What? It's not. It's Shang now.
You're right.
No, it is not.
Shang now.
I can see. I just mean to say, at the time, I see why you were like, oh, yeah, whatever.
But I own 40% of the Arby's commercial now.
We hate Arby's.
It doesn't matter.
Who goes to Arby's?
Wait, hold on. We have the meats as you?
Yeah. We own that.
Wait, what? Get the out of here.
All right. That is the most. Victor's got to call Ian, buddy. Yeah.
A ghost in here, nigga? Y'all niggas got speakers in here?
What movie's that from?
Y'all niggas got speakers in here?
No one's gonna guess that. My ducks, my swans, welcome to the pond.
My name is Dorian from group82music.com, and right here we got Pusha T talking about how he got paid $500,000 for the da-da-da-da-da, I'm loving it with McDonald's, and he owns 40% of the Arby's you got the meats. Now, when it comes to getting inside of commercials and television and video games, anybody can do this. Like, this is something you don't need a label for. I haven't had this happen, but the people I know that have had it happen, everybody has had to sign some sort of publishing agreement for this to happen. See, each of these shows, these commercials, these video games, they have music supervisors. There's even an organization in LA that I was a part of at one time called the Guild of Music Supervisors. They have events like every month, every other month, and you go there and you rub elbows with people to get your music in that shit. Bunch of tap dancing is what it is. But at the end of the day, you need to have someone who knows somebody inside of one of these publishing companies, and they're gonna get your song placed. Now, when that happens, you get two payments. You get the upfront payment, which is what Pusha T got right here for $500,000, and then you can get royalties on the back end. Obviously, the reason that Pusha T regrets this is because he just took the upfront $500,000. He didn't get the royalties on the back end. He opted out of that. This is fucking McDonald's. I'm loving it has been around for what? Fucking 15, 20 years now? So every time that commercial gets played, he would have gotten paid forever. Now, we have the meats. I'm pretty sure he did something a little bit different, and he got the royalties on that every single time. This is why you always gotta own your music. This is why you always gotta own your jingles. This is why you always have to make sure you're getting your royalties, you're getting your publishing. When you sign to a label, you're gonna sign away ownership of your music. They're going to own it. All the opportunities that they give you, all these placements that they give you, these shows they do, all these things that they do for you, they keep the money. And if you do enough, your fan base is big enough, yeah, you'll make some millions. But when you're making millions, they're making billions. And you're the person that wrote this. You're the person that picked that beat. You're the person that has the talent. Why in the hell should they get 90-95% of the revenue off of that? If anything, it should be equal 50-50. But most deals are not like that. And then on top of that, they might make you pay for the relationships. Let's say a publishing house might charge the label a consulting fee in order to get that song placed for $20,000. You think that label's going to pay that $20,000 out of their pocket? No, they're going to pay it out of your budget. And you got to pay that back through recoupment. Streams, album sales. You got a 360 deal, might be through a feature, might be through touring, or that might eat into the upfront payment, the advance that you might have got for that song being placed. They always find a way to fuck you, every single time. These are things you got to be conscious of when you sign with a label, because these publishing houses, they have relationships with labels, and that's what they want. And they know that they can get a lot more money with a label than they can with an independent artist. When you're independent stuff, you deal with, it's how it is. If you want to do things on your own, you're going to have to be outside the system, and you're going to have to keep finding ways to bust these doors down. Or you can get inside of the system, and people will walk you into those rooms and sit you down in a throne and serve you steak and lobster while they're sending you the bill for all that shit. You want the facade, or you want the real shit? Nigga like me, I want the real shit. If you an artist who wants that real shit, you're on Instagram, click the link in the bio. Purchase one of our packages for 60% off. If you're on YouTube, click the link in the description box and purchase one of our packages for 60% off. If you somebody that wants the facade, I don't know what the fuck to tell you. I don't deal with motherfuckers like that. I only deal with the real. I'm after pond. Y'all stay true.
Okay. Rubbing on your booty because I want a little taste.
Locate, locate.
Chicka, chicka, chicka when I snap your leg.
Obey, obey.
All the pretty girls, let me see you see.
Rotate, rotate.
Ba 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 ba. I'm loving it.
Group82music.com.